In this video, I will explain the usage of rail rotation in detail first, and share a ring example in the second half of the video. Open the rail interface. In the next few videos, I'll explain how to use all the options here. Now switch to the right view and use the vertical mirror curve to draw a profile of the ring. Select Profile, then open the Rail tool. Choose Rotation and then OK. Set the number to 12. Change the direction to Plane X. Press Space to generate. After generating, you can open the control points to continue editing. Since surfaces have a record history, the rings will change when the profile is changed. Now let me explain how this tool works. We just selected Plane X. So the profile wraps around the x-axis to create the surface. The number of command prompt is the number of profiles. In addition to making rings, it can also make bezels for gems. Find the database icon. Take a bezel profile of a gemstone. Open the tool. Bezel is small, so the number of profiles can be changed to 10. If you change the direction to plane Y, then the profile will rotate around the vertical axis in the center. Press space to generate. Modify the profile to change the diameter of the bezel. Moving on to the command prompt options. Plane Z axis. It's the axis that faces our current view. So it will rotate like this. Now let's go to the front view. Change it to 12. Plane Z. And then we'll go to the right view and do that again. So what if I generated in the right view? What will it look like? You'll see the result is very strange. You need to rotate the profile by 90 degrees to make it work. So remember the direction of the plane Z axis. It's the axis facing the current view. Next, let's learn the rest of the three directions. Modify the center of the curve. Look at the axis of the curve. Put the start point on this axis. I'm going to draw an hourglass half. Select the curve. Change the axis. So how do I determine this axis? Look at the small axis in the corner. It's currently the y-axis facing up. So we should select Object Y-axis. You'll see that this rotates the center of the curve. If we move the curve, the surface will move with it. Because when we move the curve, the axis of the curve changes. So there's one thing you need to be aware of. When I'm in front view, do I have to select Object Z axis for the rail tool? Actually, no. We're still going to select Object Y axis. Because when we created this curve, we were in top view. In this view, the Y axis is facing up. So remember, the axis of this object will change as the object is moved or rotated. Now I'm going to switch to top view to create the curve. Look at the corner the axis has changed. This time I'll move the curve away from the center axis. Because the curve was created in the current view. So by referring to the small axis, the vertical axis should be the Z axis. If I want to change the diameter of the center hole, how should I do it? I can't move the curve directly. I need to open the control point and then modify the position. Because changing the control points doesn't change the position of the axis. It's the axis of the curve. Let's move on to the other two axes. Look at the horizontal axis here. Draw a profile above it. The axis reference is in the corner. Select the x-axis. Open up the control points to modify the surface in real time. Let's move on to the last axis. Change to the right view. Draw a profile. Now the z-axis is facing up. Switch to top view. As we've learned before, the z-axis is facing the current view. So when you rotate it, it should look like this. Now use it to generate a surface. And that's it. This is the direction of the curved z-axis. Next, I'll use the rail rotation tool in combination with other tools and share an example of a ring design. Now let's make this ring. Switch to the front view. Create a ring size. Switch to the right view. Use the vertical mirror curve. Hold down Alt and snaps it to the circular curve. Remember to turn on orthogonality. I'm going to draw a ring profile. I will put twisted rope on both sides. And in the center, I want to set the diamond. Press D to close the curve. And curve the inside of the ring. This will make it more comfortable to wear. Open up the control points and adjust the shape. Okay, then open the rail tool. X-axis. And then open up the profile control points to adjust it. Widen the sides. Adjust the groove for the stone. Next, find extract isocurve. Extract a curve here. Go to front view. Project the curve to C-plane. Now use gem on curve. Fit to the ring. Drag the point to control the range of the gem. Use the arrows to adjust the gem diameter. Here I am using the equal spacing mode. Generally, the gems are spaced at 0.15. Right-click to edit. Gem height is too low. Raise the gem. Now the gems are created. Then create the micro prongs. In the future, I will make a video dedicated to explain in detail the usage of the tools gem on curve and prong for gem on curve. For now, it's just a simple application. Increase the height. Can be slanted outward. Generate. Uniform surface normal. Now I'm going to put twisted ropes on both sides. In the same way, extract the curves. Then use the rope tool. Adjust the ropes. Thicken it. Generate. Open the profile control points and change the width on both sides. Move the twisted rope inward a bit. And finally, revolve the rope 180 degrees. That's all for this video. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share this video, and subscribe to us. See you next time.